It was at the start of the Dubai Air Show that Emirates announced that it would be ordering an additional 65 777X aircraft with options to convert airframes from the mid-size Dash 9 to the larger Dash 10 or smaller Dash 8. The Dash 9 is the only aircraft that's even close to being certified and entering service at this point. But there is huge interest in a Dash 10 variant which would come closer to Emirates sufficiently replacing its Airbus A380s when their time is up. But it's not just about stretching the fuselage. So what considerations need to be made to get such a jet developed? Let's take a look. Commenting on the 777-10 study, Sheikh Ahmed bin Said Al Maktoum, Chairman and Chief Executive, Emirates Airline and Group, said, "Emirates has been open about the fact that we are keen for manufacturers to build larger capacity aircraft, which are more efficient to operate, especially with projected air traffic growth and increasing constraints at airports. We fully support Boeing's feasibility study to develop the 777-10 and have options to convert our latest 777-9 order to the 777-10 or the 777-8. The airline wants to be able to accommodate 50-plus passengers on board the Dash 10, adding about 16 feet or around 5 meters to the Dash 9. This would take overall length to 268 feet, nearly 82 meters. There's a lot to consider when offering stretched variants. As reported by Aviation Week, Boeing says a 777-10 technical feasibility study will be, quote, driven largely by takeoff performance requirements. The media outlet says that the focus is mainly on whether the aircraft could meet current critical engine failure certification rules. Aviation Week, in speaking with Boeing's Justin Hale, customer leader for the 777X, adds that the 777X's electronic tail skid protection system would protect the aircraft from over-rotation with the existing main landing gear. Hale told the website, "It's more about the impact on takeoff performance." And so a 777-10 evaluation will cover performance on takeoff, but also examine things like structural weight and payload range changes, all the things that a study would have to go look at, Hale says. With a heavier aircraft still relying on two engines, the impact of an engine failure must be seriously considered. Takeoff distance and climb rate in such scenarios will also need to be calculated, and designers must also look at controllability. And while technical feasibility is one thing, commercial feasibility is another. Is it worth it for Boeing to undertake the time, effort, and expense of developing and certifying this new variant for just a few airlines? If it's Emirates taking interest, it's probably worth it, given their likely commitment to dozens of airframes. But who knows? Maybe that still won't be enough for Boeing. What do you think? Is it worth developing a 777-10 if only Emirates is buying? Is the 777-9 big enough? Let us know your thoughts by leaving a comment. In addition to our daily YouTube videos, Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.